Everything about Mount Zion is so unique.
The lectures actually open you to get you exposed to things you don't know.
Most of the things that we believe we know and something that we never thought of always come up.
It's a combination of people who have attended the Mount Zion Institute, OCP and ACP class. It's an opportunity for drama ministers to rock mind, to share experiences, especially experiences that have to do with mission field experiences. We share together challenges.
About the Holy Ghost breakfast held every morning here. It's been an experience with God.
Wow, talking about the Holy Ghost breakfast, this is just another piece of, I don't know, every morning we are delivered from things that we did not know that we had in our lives.
And the Executive Director of Mozambique Films Production, Nigeria. I'm inviting everyone to the next National Drama Minister's Power Night.
What is Power Night? You want to know?
Power Night?
Yes.
It's a power.
Yes.
Not ordinary power. Power of God.
Power of God.
It's a night of power of God for ministers of God who are ready to rekindle their fire.
It's a wonderful program that you cannot even explain. You cannot explain it until you come to this.
We love you. Jesus, we love you every day. We bless and magnify your name. We bless and magnify your holy name. Jesus, will let your heart pray.
Raise your voice and sing. here, young man. You bother me with your sermons. You are sacked already. And your appointment with my company is terminated. And you see, I'm not ready to reverse my action.
From the distance pass.
Abemi, thanks for coming in on time. Some forces have been talking to my heart for quite some time.
No, Baba, you see, my daughter said the Mark 66 is his evil. She said the one president is Satan in flesh.
In the present future,
law student expelled for rape.
But suddenly, something just happened.
You're not ugly. You're not insane.
The joy in my heart when I suddenly realized the possible possibilities.
By His divine grace and power, they have come on this evangelistic journey. Now it is 30 years of dramatic journey in the ministerial adventure, and the journey has just begun. The Mount Zion Faith Ministries International, Nigeria, invites everyone to the 30th year anniversary celebration with series of soul-lifting events. On Thursday, 20th August 2015, from 4 p.m., shall be screening of four different movies. And on Friday, 21st August 2015, from 4 p.m., shall be drama ministration from various drama ministries. And the grand finale comes on Saturday, 22nd August 2015, 30th anniversary program of Mount Zion Faith Ministries International. Special feature will be graduation ceremony of Diploma Certificate Program of Mozambique Institute of Christian Drama. Venue, Jogos Center, off Liberty Road, Ring Road, Ibadan. Hooray! Mozambique Faith Ministries is 30 years, August 20th to 22nd, 2015. You are all invited.
I know. He will come earlier. I don't even know what I've done wrong to this Mr. Soji. Every time, give your life to Jesus.
Give your life to Jesus. Is it the only one as a Christian in this office?
I wonder. I just don't understand it.
Instead of him going about his assignment, he's busy preaching about. Is he a preacher in this office or a worker?
Whenever you are doing your secular job, you should take God's work seriously too. That is what God enjoined his children to do. And so, he's right.
I know you will support me. You are the same.
Yes, of course. Birds of the same feather flock together.
Thank you. We shall consider a younger brother to Jesus.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
You're welcome, sir.
You. Tell your brother to come.
Giving me everything that is inside today. I pray that I will use it for your glory in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father.
Daddy Soji, please have your seat.
Thank you, sir.
What about the assignment I gave to you?
I'll tell you, sir.
Oh, please. Very Mr. Desoji, it's a very good job.
I really appreciate you. I appreciate you very well. You see,
you are always helpful to this company. Thank you very much. I appreciate you.
Thanks for the compliment, sir. Sir, I have a word for you.
And what is it?
The Holy Spirit just ministered to me to inform you that you need Jesus.
Mr. Adesoji, I've told you, please, if you don't have genuine word to tell me,
stop your sermon. Yes, stop your sermon. I am a Christian too. I'm a Christian. What's wrong with you? I've told you several times that I'm satisfied with the way I'm serving the Lord. Stop your sermon.
I'm sorry, sir. I was just prompted by the Holy Spirit.
I have the Holy Spirit in me too. You are not the only one that has the Holy Spirit. So, let me be.
I'm sorry.
See, Mr. Adesoji, I know you are a very intelligent and hardworking person in this company. If you have any idea or anything that will move this company forward, you can come and tell me. But Samuel, no.
Adesoji, could you please stand up for recognition?
Good afternoon, sir.
Mr. Adesoji, you are welcome. Actually, your MD has told us a lot about you. You are welcome to our midst. You are very much welcome.
Thank you very much, sir, for the opportunity given to me to be part of this meeting today. I am most appreciative. Thank you, sirs.
Mr. Adesoji, we discovered that the situation of things in this country is a little bit very tight. And despite all this, we discovered that your company kept on progressing. I mean, you are making progress every day. We want to know, please, how have you been doing that? I mean, can you tell us some of your secrets?
Thank you, sir. It's been God. In fact, I cannot say how God has been doing it. All I know is that it is God that has been doing it.
Look, Mr. Adesoji, we all have this God you're talking about, or you don't want to tell us your secret?
Secret? I don't have any other secret other than God. And we have dedicated workers who are honest and diligent in their works.
My friends, I told you I don't have any hidden agenda towards my business.
Mr. Adesoji.
Yes, sir.
Please, you can go.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Holy Spirit, help me.
Mr. Adesoji, anything the matter?
Yes, sir.
What is it?
Sirs, I have this thing that is troubling my heart. It's telling me that I have not spoken the truth.
I said it. This man is hiding something from us. I said it.
Sir, I'm sorry. My MD has warned that I should not speak about this subject matter again in this company.
You told us that this man has been helping you in this company. Now you don't want him to help us too? That's absolutely unfair to us all. It's unfair to us.
Mr. Adesoji, what is it? We are all here. I know you and your MD are hiding some things from us. Tell us.
Sir, I'm sorry. My MD has warned that I should not speak about this subject matter again in this company.
Look, Mr. Man. You are wasting our time. What is the secret?
The Holy Spirit told me to tell you that you need the one who can sustain you in time of crisis. If you can accept him, he will turn your situation around. When people are saying there is a casting down, not for you, it will be a lifting up. Everything in your business will be working well.
Wait, Mr. Adesoji, you are not calling yourself. We are all Christians.
And we know this Jesus Christ we are talking about. So therefore, don't bring any Jesus to the economic situation of this country, okay?
Adesoji, but I told you not to preach to those people who are already Christians. We all know Jesus. Why? Why are you preaching to those people who are already Christian? For God's sake, it is only those people who are yet to know Jesus that you're supposed to be preaching to. Eh? Adesoji? Adesoji? For God's sake!
Look here, Mr. Adesoji. My pastor knows me very well. Because I am the babaijo of my church. I'm their patron in that church. So, and I've been trying my own capacity to buy things for the church. So what are we saying here?
Abio, I wonder, I'm the patron of the choir in my church.
Only recently, I bought musical instrument worth millions of naira to the choir department. And not too long ago, I even sent about 4 choir members to the United States to go and further their studies. So what are we talking about here? What else do you want us to do that we have not done, Mr. Adesoji?
I am very sorry, sir. I am not trying to condemn you. I am only trying to follow the instruction of the Holy Spirit.
All right, Mr. Adesoji. You can now go. That's all right.
Badmus Ajanaku, you have a big problem, and you don't know it. But you soon know it, because the man you said is helping you. He's a religious fanatic. I will still keep him in your office. Very soon, he will destroy you with his prayers.
Well, I don't have problem at all, because I have stopped him from preaching or praying in this office. But you are the one who gave him permission even to preach.
Badmus, I have an advice for you. You better do something fast before Agbani Kaka and Fori Omolomo Gunseoro deals with you.
Don't worry. I've gotten what I needed from him.
What exactly do you want to do? All hail bani kaka. All hail Agbani Kaka. I greet you all tonight. Agbani Kaka said the economic situation of this country will be dealt with. He also said he will call the president and the people in authority to order, and everything will work in your favor.
Great one. Things are becoming unbearable for us. Agbani Kaka should act fast. My business is crumbling.
Jesus. Ah, Heavenly Father, I have come to you again this night. I pray that you will fight my battle for me. In the mighty name of Jesus, wherever my enemies are, whatever they are doing right now, whatever they are doing that is against my life, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, I pray that you scatter them. In the name of Jesus, arise and let my enemy be scattered. In the name of Jesus, Father, I have come to you. Arise on my behalf. Fight my battle for me. Lord, arise on my behalf. Fight my battle for me. In the name of Jesus, my workplace, oh Lord, I pray that you will take charge of that place. In the name of Jesus, you commit the heart of my director to your hand. You rule the heart of the kings. You rule the heart of the chiefs. In the mighty name of Jesus, you are arrested. You will gain his heart for you. You will gain his heart for yourself. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Agbani Kaka is sounding a note of warning to you, Badmus. He said, you are harboring fire in your bosom. He said, it's high time you put the fire out before it burns you. You are enjoying the fire now, but when it burns, it will be very disastrous.
My lord, great one, I've gotten what I needed from you, and I have a plan to put out the fire very soon.
You better do it fast before you get burnt.
Yes, my lord.
And to the rest of you, you know, we decide the future of the country. You shall be relieved very soon, says Agbani Kaka.
Hey, Agbani Kaka.
I know I heard the Spirit of God telling me to speak. I have sowed the seed, and I know it will bear fruit one day.
Yes, come in. Mr. Lawrence, how are you?
Please,
help you sit.
Please.
Yes, how may I help you?
I have a problem, which I believe only your God can solve for me. Sir, I am a Christian. I go to church. I pay all the money we are asked to pay. But my problem still remains the same.
Mr. Lawrence, this is an office hour. And I would not want to do contrary to what the management has said concerning preaching. The only thing you need is Jesus Christ. But please, let us see after the closing hour.
Sir, I can't. My mind told me to come and meet you. That's why I'm here. Why are you postponing this matter till closing hour?
I can
can I go against the rule of this organization?
Sir, see, my wife's life is in danger. There's this problem we are facing in our family. For so many years now, there's no solution. Sir, please. Please, sir, help me.
Holy Spirit, help me. This is a temptation. Okay. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Bless your name. Mr. Lawrence.
Jesus Christ is the only solution to your problems. You see, your money or anything you do in the church do not really matter to God as much as your life. You need to give your life to Jesus Christ.
How do you mean, sir? Sir, I am a worker in my church. In fact, I'm an usher. And I did my work diligently.
Those are services in the church. You see, the real thing is giving your life to Jesus Christ. You said you're an usher in the church. But Mr. Lawrence, you see, frequently visit the bar. Most times you drink to stupor. You are drunk most times.
Does that really mean? Because in our church, both pastors and members drink.
You don't see what, Mr. Lawrence? You don't see a special thing in that?
Yes. Yes.
It's so special. It's not good. God cannot contradict himself. He said you cannot serve two masters. It's either you love one and hate the other. Mr. Lawrence, if you really want to be free from all your problems, you need Jesus Christ.
You mean if I accept him, he will solve all my problems?
Mr. Lawrence, you see, the greatest problem you need to tackle is to defeat that great enemy, the devil. And you cannot do that without having Jesus Christ in your life. You need to give your life to Jesus Christ. He has the power to solve all problems. You can decide to do otherwise. My prayer for you is that God will solve your problems speedily in Jesus' name. Please, give your life to him. Do not waste time.
Sir. If that is the case, I'm ready. I'm ready.
I'm coming.
But if you continue, that is the finish. guys. Let us go.
Mr. John Folonwosho, what did you say you heard about Mr. Adesoji?
Sir, I heard that the general manager was involved in a shady business with someone. That was why he was attacked by some people. Sir, I know. He's just preaching around with the word of God in his office. He's just deceiving us by preaching around with the word of God.
I thought I was the only person that heard about it. Sir, I would like you to investigate the matter very well. I don't know how he could be attacked if he wasn't involved in this city business.
Thanks to every one of you, I will investigate the matter. If Mr. Adesoji is found guilty, then we'll know what to do about him.
Sir, you said I should see you after the
meeting. Yeah. In the meantime, you will be acting on behalf of Mr. Adesoji.
Ah!
wow. Congrats. Congratulations.
Honestly, I don't understand, sir. When they were beating me, one of them said that it was a warning. That if I continued, I would be killed. But I couldn't ask them to continue what? I was left on the floor and they went away.
Did you do any business with someone and you did not settle that person very well?
Business? No. I didn't do any business with anybody. But what I know is that God will fight for me, sir.
Okay. I will still investigate the matter. And whoever is involved, punished.
Thank you very much, sir. I'm so grateful.
Soji, take time to rest. I'm not expecting you in the office very soon.
And it's my prayer that God will continue to protect us from all those sinful people.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Amen.
Sir, now, on behalf of the management and the staff of the company, we have come to congratulate you, thanking God for sparing your life. Actually, I mean the life of our GM. And we pray that God will always be with you.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I'm so excited. I'm happy that you came again. I pray that God's protection will be upon you.
Amen.
Amen.
You see, I was surprised when the hoodlum attacked me. One thing they said that I cannot forget in a hurry is, this is a warning. If you continue, we'll kill you. I don't understand it myself. Yes, the first one said, let's finish him. And then the second one said, no, let's teach him a lesson. And I now said, this is a warning.
Sir, continue what?
I still don't understand. But I know that God is in charge.
Sir, this is contrary to what we heard about you. What we heard was that you had some shady business with some group of people. That's why you attacked.
No. 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 That's a lie. I mean, it's a lie from the pit of hell. You know I'm a child of God. And I preach against shady business. How would I be involved in what I preach against? No. It's the plan of the devil to dent my image. But God is alive, and I believe that God's plan will prevail. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Sir, we believed you. Because you are good to us too. We could see that in your actions and your words, even in your day-to-day activities in the office. We thank God for God sparing your life. And we pray God will always be with you. Always.
Amen.
Amen. God will be with you.
Oh, once again, thank you very much. We appreciate you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We have been discharged.
Thank you so much. That's good. That's good. Adam, you have been discharged. That's very good. I'm so happy. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. I appreciate you.
I pray that God will lift you up.
also pray. You'll be great in Jesus' name.
Amen, sir. Amen, sir. Sir, you are very good to me and my family. And how could I leave you in that condition and run away? And I thank God that you are alive also today. So you deserve it, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
When the enemy came, they actually wanted to finish my life. But Ajani rescued me when they left.
Bad boss! Agbani Kaka said he will not spare you. He said you have to be punished. Because you have allowed that man to stay too long in your domain.
Great one. Help me. I thought I can use him and lay him off immediately. Please help me.
No, Badmus. Agbani Kaka said you have to be punished. And this is your punishment. Badmus, you will have to sleep with a popular mad woman in the town for 7 days. 7 good days, Badmus.
Great one, help me. Sleeping with a popular mad woman is a great shame to me. Help me.
That is fine, Badmus. If you refuse to do what Agbani Kaka said, then you will die after 2 days.
Help me.
Badmus. Have you gotten the mad woman that the Agbani Kaka asked you to sleep with?
Great one. I've searched for the popular mad woman. The one I saw was not so popular. I learned the popular mad woman has left the city a few days ago.
Since you have begged Agbani Kaka to forgive you, we are giving you another 21 days to look for the mad woman and do what Agbani Kaka asked you to do with her.
Great one, I will look for her. I will look for her.
On hail Agbani Kaka!
Yes, come in.
Oh! Good morning, sir. You are welcome, sir. You are welcome, sir.
Good morning,
welcome, sir.
Good morning, everybody.
Thank God for your life. Thank God. Thank God for God healing you very fast.
Thank you very much. I really appreciate you all. And thank you for being there for me. Thank you for your visitations from time to time. Thank you for your calls from time to time. You are loving.
You don't fall sick
in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Sir, the chairman asked me to give you this.
The chairman is around?
Yes, sir.
I have to go and see him at once. Well, my people, I really appreciate your commitment towards me. The Lord bless you in Jesus' name.
Good to have you back.
Thank you very much. What? What is this? Am I
dreaming? This is reality. No. No.
Ah, Mr. Adesoji. You are welcome. How are you? Thank God you are back on your feet.
Thank God, sir. But I'm not fine. I received this letter this morning, but I don't understand it.
Is the letter not explicit enough?
Yes, it is, but I don't know what I have done to warrant this letter.
Well, the company said they don't need your service any longer, period.
The company said that.
A Christian, and you still involve yourself in shady business.
No.
I don't need your explanation at all.
I am through with you. Yeah, I'm through with you.
Not you. We give glory to God. Give glory to God. I'll see you.
All hail Agbani Kaka. Last day for Badmus. The decision has been made and there is no going back.
Great one. It is difficult for me to do. I cannot sleep with a mad woman. Please, let Agbani Kaka change my punishment. I have sent the man away from my office.
Badmus, you know whatever Agbani Kaka said can never be changed. I am not in position to change what he has said. And you know that.
Look, I cannot do it. How can I sleep with a mad woman? I cannot do it.
Then, prepare for your downfall from now.
Badmus, don't play with fire.
I am not playing with fire. Can you all sleep with a mad woman? If that be the decision of Abanikaka, then I cannot do it. I'm sick of him.
Leave him alone. Let him go. He's still coming back to do what Abanikaka has commanded.
By then, you will have improved.
Thank you very much.
You are welcome, sir.
I'm happy. And how about the bill?
The bill is in the case file.
Right. I'll get it.
Okay, sir.
Thank you. It's all right.
Oga, she has gone.
Okay.
And I see for ya, that's just a little bit of a thing. In fact, the bar she can buy.
Boya le madame.
Chief is sick?
Yes.
Ibu no wa bai.
Who an word bai?
Ni hospital.
Ben.
Ibu no word wa.
Take a lot, sibe.
Soji, it's a long story. Chief has been in pain for some time now. He cannot even sleep. See, he can't talk.
Jesus Christ. Chief, can you hear me? Can you hear me?
You at this moment just because of Jesus. Your prayer worked wonders for him. Chief cannot sit down like this for some days now. Mr. Desoji, thank you. Thank you.
Desoji. So, you can still come back to me after what I've done to you.
Sir, God is not like men. We should give glory to God who forgives iniquities.
I have wronged you in many ways. I need your forgiveness. Please forgive me.
Sir, Jesus Christ has brought you back to life for a purpose. And I don't want us to miss out that purpose. It is important for you to give your life to Jesus now. You must surrender your life to him, because he's ready to fight your battle. In other words, if you fail to surrender your life to him, because we don't know what can happen in the next few minutes, he may not fight for you. But God is interested in you, and he won't fight for you. Please surrender your life to him.
With what I've just witnessed now, Chief, we need to consider giving our life to Jesus Christ. We need to give our life to Jesus Christ. It is high time.
Even if I'm going to die now, I need that Jesus. I need him in my life.
Sir, you're not even going to die.
since you did not die before I came in, that means that God wants to bring out something out of your life. Sir, madam, are you ready to give your life to Jesus now?
Yes. I am ready to give my life to Jesus.
It's okay, sir. Just relax yourself. Chief, let us pray. Close your eyes, madam, please. Close your eyes and say these prayers after me. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
I appreciate your greatness over my life.
I appreciate your greatness in my life.
I have come to you today. Please save my life.
I summon this urgent meeting. Bad Mons has crossed to the other side. We must not allow him to reveal our secrets. We have to act fast.
What shall we do? Do we attack him physically or spiritually?
We must not allow him to go like that. Bad Mons is a traitor. He must die for his offense.
We will kill him bit by bit. We will attack him spiritually and physically. It must not just go like that. No! No! No!
Now that you have begun to enjoy Jesus in your life, I will need to bring my pastor to you to come and pray with you in the morning. And then teach you the word of God for total deliverance.
The type of joy I'm experiencing now, I don't know how to explain it. I just thank God because there is joy in my home. There is joy in the life of me and my husband. And do you know, I never knew that Chief has gone so far. He only told us that these people, they are his business associates, not knowing that they are cult members. Ah! God, I thank you, Mr. Adesoji. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Chief.
Madam, joy has come to permanently stay in your home.
Amen.
Since you have given your life to Jesus Christ, who is able to do exceedingly above what you ask for or think. Let us pray. My Lord Jesus, I thank you because
Insta. You are welcome, sir.
Good morning, yeah.
You are welcome, sir.
Yeah, good morning. Good morning.
We checked you in your main house, you were not there. And you know this is the next place for the
day. Thank you very much. Well, I didn't expect to come here to rest because people have been coming, disturbing me. So I said I should come here to this secluded area to come and rest. Thank you very much. You are welcome. Thank you.
You see, Bad Mons, I'm very sorry. I was away to the States. That's why I couldn't visit you in the hospital. I'm very sorry.
Yeah, never mind, Chief Robinson. Jesus has healed me now. I've been healed completely. Thank you, Jesus.
Well, anyway, we have come for two major reasons. Madam, you will have to excuse us.
Well, you can discuss whatever thing you want to discuss with me in our presence.
That is not possible. And you know it. This is men's talk.
real men's talk, and you know it. So she has to excuse us, okay?
Only, please, I will excuse you. Only excuse you.
Well, what is it that you want to discuss with me?
Badmus, why did you have to do that? Eh? Why did you have to betray Agbani Kaka? Eh?
Betrayed who? I've not betrayed anybody. Your God, who take delight in killing me? I did not betray him. I did not betray him at all. Your God is a killer God. But thanks be to Jesus who has delivered me from death.
Agbani Kaka has already forgiven you. Please, you have to come back to us, okay? Come back to us.
I can never come back. And I will never come back. I cannot come back because I've seen the light.
Badmus, don't joke with Agbani Kaka. He has power over his subjects.
Point of correction. I am not his subject any longer. Jesus Christ is my leader. I beg you all to come and taste Jesus Christ. Come and taste him too.
What do you mean? That is an abomination, you know. Agbani Kaka is our savior. Agbani Kaka has been helping us. How you know it? Look, we have vowed, we have promised that we are going to serve, we are going to stay by him, we are going to serve Agbani Kaka till the very end. Look, Badmus, you are playing with fire. You are playing with fire. You better come back to us before it is too late. Better come back. Come back, Badmus, come back.
I cannot come back. I cannot come back. Jesus Christ has paid it all on the cross of Calvary. I am free from the hooks and griefs of Agbani Kaka. I cannot die, but live to declare the word of Jesus Christ to all of you who are yet to know his power.
You are adamant. You are too audacious. Look here, Badmus. Agbani Kaka will send you a message very soon. I mean, very soon.
Well, Jesus Christ will be waiting for his message.
Badmus, don't joke with your life. We don't want to lose you now. Please, reconsider your stand.
I and my family have declared our allegiance to the Lord Jesus Christ, and we are not going back.
Robinson, let's go. This man is stubborn. We shall see who is powerful. We shall soon discover that. Let's go. Look, Badmus. Bikuno loko ni, bipakute ni, ipade doju ala.
I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. no turning back, no turning back.
Badmoss, I have come to give you the last warning.
I am not coming back. Yes, I have decided for my Lord Jesus Christ.
The big ones have sent me to you before fire begins to burn you and your business.
You are wrong, Owonikoko. Jesus Christ has opened another chapter for me and my business.
Well, you are given the last warning here. If you don't come back between now and the next 7 days, your children had better begin preparation for your funeral.
Oh, Woni Koko, you go tell your Agbani Kaka that Jesus Christ will be waiting for you. I denounce Agbani Kaka 100 times.
Badmoss, have you forgotten so easily? Have you forgotten what happened to Chief Agbani, who refused to follow the instruction of Agbani Kaka and met his Waterloo? He met his untimely death. Have you forgotten?
See, that is Agbani, not Badmoss. I have found my Lord Jesus Christ, and he told me no more death for me and my family. See, please come and try this Jesus.
Badmoss, I have sworn my allegiance to Agbani Kaka, and there is no way to come back.
How? Owonikoko, Jesus is sweeter than the Agbani Kaka.
You have won.
Badmus has defiled Agbanikaka. He has to see the fight of Agbanikaka. He said Agbanikaka is a killer god. Oh. Badmus has defiled Agbanikaka. Oh. And we are here tonight to come and prove to him that Agbanikaka is still powerful. All hail Agbanikaka! All hail Agbanikaka! Agbanikaka, this is the image representing Badmus in this amiable society. The man that you have helped to the top, and after getting to the top, he defied you. He said you are no more powerful. Tonight, deal with him as you used to do to those people that defies you. Make his home a place of money. Turn his wife a widow. And turn his children fatherless. Tonight, we will hear the bad news of Badmus. Good evening, gentlemen.
Thank you very much, sir.
How may I help you?
We are here concerning the business we discussed the other time, sir.
Business? Is that so?
Business.
Okay. This is my house. I don't miss pleasure with business. If you want to discuss business with me, I think you still know my office. Yeah, I'm going to discuss business with me. Come to my office. Okay?
I'm very sorry, sir.
No problem. No problem. Yeah. Yeah. Regards to your family. Anybody in that kitchen? Thank you.
No. I cannot accept that. Yes, Mr. Adesoji, you have to come back to the office. Yes. You are a child of God now. You must forgive and forget.
Sir, I'm doing consultancy job now. And it pains me than coming back to that office.
I've said no. Mr. Adesoji, wait a minute.
I have promoted you to the post of one of the directors of this company.
You are no more a manager, but a director of administration. Yes.
Okay, sir. Please, let me pray over it. If the Lord wants me to come back, I will. Otherwise, I can only be a consultant to that company.
Okay, quickly pray about it. I'll be waiting for your reply tomorrow.
No, Chief. Please, give me some time to pray over it. I'll get back to you, please.
All right. I'll be praying here too. Goodbye.
I said I don't need any chief. Jesus.
Hello?
Hello, Chief Magnus is your friend, though. He's been clamoring your name since last night.
Clamoring my name? How?
Yes, he's in the hospital right now. I don't know. Please help me. Help me. I don't want to lose my husband. Please come over to the hospital right now.
Okay. I'm on my way.
Thank you, sir. I'll be expecting you, sir. Oh my goodness.
Madam?
Yes?
Relax. Jalal is in control.
Thank you. Thank you, nurse. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Hello?
Hello, Mr. Adesoji.
Hello, sir.
A call just came in not long ago that Chief Akeju is sick in the hospital.
What happened?
I don't know. But the wife said he was clamoring my name.
Ah. Clamoring your name? Why?
I just don't know. Eh? I don't know.
So, what are you suggesting, sir?
I want to go to the hospital now to go and preach and to go and preach to him, and after all, pray for him.
Chief, hold on. You can't go there alone. I'm on my way home right now. But I will join you very soon.
I only need to pick my pastor, okay? Please wait. As soon as I get home,
then I will pick my pastor and then I will meet you up. Don't go alone, please. Wait. Wait for us.
Ah, okay. That's very good. That's very nice. Ah, I will appreciate that. Ah, I will appreciate it. Thank you very much.
All right.
Badmus, why? Why are you doing this to me? Eh? It was your image we presented before Agbani Kaka. Not mine. Yeah, my head. My back. Yeah. Why are you so wicked, Badmus? Why? Why?
Chief Akeju, it is because I am no longer in your camp. I am now in the camp of the Lord Jesus Christ. I am a brand new person.
My bad! Badmus, why are you hitting me hard like this? Badmus, stop it! Yeah, stop it, Badmus! Badmus, stop it! Stop it! Stop it! Stop it! Oh, stop it!
I can now understand the situation, Oni, and I warned you. I warned you to stop it already. You insisted that the chief is a betrayer, that he has betrayed your people. Can you see what you have caused me now? Chief, help me. My husband must not die.
Mama Shola, get up, sit down.
I am not here to fight your husband, but I'm here to plead for mercy for him. You see, I know he did it in ignorance, but my God has already fought for me. I'm not here to fight him.
That is why I brought this man of God to come and pray for him.
Look! I don't need your prayers, wicked Badmus. All I need from you is to leave me alone. Oh, Badmus, get your hand off me! Get your hand off me!
Chief, this is another chance for you. God loves you. That's why you are still alive today. Accept him.
Who died?
Who was that? Who died?
The person that caught said Chief Owonikoko just died.
Come to the Lord Jesus Christ. You said you presented my image before Agbani Kaka. But instead, you and your colleague were affected. Come to Jesus. Eh? Now you will know that there is a superpower behind me that is taking care of me. You better come to Jesus now. Come.
Ah, it is too late. I can't turn back from Agbani Kaka. It is too late.
Agbani Kaka? Oh, what are you calling him? Is he one tormenting you?
No! No, it's Badmoss. Oh, Badmoss. Get your hand off me, Badmoss. Get your hand off me.
Agbani Kaka, or what do you call him? Is he one tormenting you? See, Badmoss cannot be the one tormenting you. It's the devil that put you in bondage. Come to Jesus and he will deliver you.
Chief, please listen to me. The Bible says, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. The position you are right now, the devil has placed a heavy load upon you. But when you meet with Jesus, that heavy load will be taken off and God will give you rest.
Is it by force? I said it is too late for me. Too late!
Chief, it is not too late. It is not too late to change your decision. It is not too late to decide for God. I remember a man by the pool of Bethsaida. Was afflicted for 38 years, but when he met with the Lord Jesus Christ, that affliction was taken away. He had rest in God. The chief, Jesus is ready for you. Once you are ready for him, all you need to do is to open the door of your heart and let him come in. This burden will be taken away. I mean, the Lord is ready to change. Yes.
I said I don't need any cheap.
But the truth of the matter is, it's never too late for a sinner to come to the Lord Jesus Christ.